I'm Bridget Green.
And I'm Kevin Weber.
And today we're talking all about third-gen AMD Ryzen Threadripper.
And the AMD Ryzen 9 3950X.
Available now!
So good to have you here, finally.
I heard you want to talk about technology. You don't have to twist my arm too hard on that topic.
I have hot gossip.
Bring up. Bridget, she's dead. You may not like it, but this is what peak performance looks like.
Welcome everyone to the Bring Up, where time sure does fly by, Kevin, because somehow this is the 1 year anniversary of our show.
And it's very pertinent too, because in our very first episode, we were talking with our wonderful friend Robert Halleck about second gen Threadripper. Mm-hmm. And now we're talking about third-gen Threadripper, which is just taking things to a ridiculous level of performance.
Seems like just yesterday. Mm-hmm. It's like we've never left this desk.
Yeah, it's like they won't let us leave.
Today we launched three amazing processors, as Kevin was mentioning, the AMD Ryzen 9 3950X, mm-hmm. as well as two new Threadripper offerings, the 3960X and the 3970X. Those are rocking 24 and 32 cores respectively.
Yeah, so if you own a Threadripper already, or you just have a workstation style system, and you find yourself frequently loading all those cores and threads at 100% during rendering or code compiling or whatever it is that you do.
It's none of our business.
Whatever it is, I think you're really going to benefit significantly from these new Threadripper chips, because for the first time, you don't really have to make any concessions between high core counts and high core speeds. Yeah. So you can just pick whichever one fits your budget and workflow best. And honestly, like, you're going to be getting the highest performance consumer desktop processor you've ever had regardless.
Yeah, it is kind of a tough choice, but the good news is that you can't really pick a
It's hard
wrong
to pick
option.
Wrong. Yeah.
One thing I really like that Robert said when we were prepping for launch is that the first and second gen Threadripper, incredible high performance. Mm-hmm. With some asterisks, right?
Yeah, some things that could be improved upon.
Third-gen Threadripper has no asterisks this time on its performance.
Yeah, they deleted all the asterisks.
And you know, you can look across our stack, you can look across our competitor's stack, you can look at your mom's house.
Look at your dad's house.
They're not gonna have performance coming anywhere near to this.
It's a little embarrassing, really.
It's a little embarrassing, but it's also really fun for us.
Yeah, it's a great time to be here at AMD.
A lot of people have asked, why did we switch to a new socket mm-hmm. for the third-gen Threadripper? And we needed the electrical power to be able to house this kind of performance.
We needed the juice.
We also wanted to be able to double the amount of PCIe lanes mm-hmm. running from the CPU to the new chipset.
Plus the introduction of PCIe Gen 4.
Yes. All of this is going to allow you to be able to plug in a lot more devices into the motherboard, all running completely uninhibited by bandwidth.
Mm-hmm. I mean, so I guess my only question now is, how am I supposed to choose between these three beautiful babies?
Oh yeah, that is tough.
It's really tough. I mean, I've been using Threadripper Gen 1 mm-hmm. and then up to Threadripper Gen 2, which is already like night and day performance
yeah.
for all my motion graphics and 3D stuff. And I don't even know what to do with Threadripper Gen 3 with that kind of speed.
Yeah, what are you going to do with all your extra time from like the rendering time it's going to save?
Well, I took a class in underwater basket weaving. And that looked promising.
Did you?
Yeah, they said I'm a natural. And honestly, this isn't even marketing cabin talking. This is like real regular cabin that uses a computer every day for work. We've been seeing the performance numbers coming in over the last couple months, and they're like so unthinkably good that it's a little weird that this is like a real product now that I can actually go out and get. I mean, ultimately, I know I'm going to be happy with any of the choices mm-hmm. I make. But how do I maximize my happiness?
Well, it's a tough decision, Kevin. And I know a lot of our viewers are probably thinking the same thing. Which of these is the right choice for me? But in true Bring Up fashion, we have an idea that, well, quite dumb. Mm-hmm. Potentially one of the dumbest.
That would actually be pretty difficult.
But I do think it might help you break down your options here. It's My Perfect Processor, the show where we help find your chip soulmate from three eligible processors. Today, we help Kevin find the computing power of his dreams. Contending for his love is the Ryzen 9 3950X, represented by Robert Halleck. The Threadripper 3960X, represented by Aaron Mayorino. And the Threadripper 3970X, represented by Bridget Green, who is definitely not me, talking right now. Now, let's help Kevin find his perfect processor.
Wow, I feel so lucky to have you all available as options. I have some questions for you. Processor 1, I already have a Ryzen 2700X at home. What makes you a good upgrade?
The fact that you already have a 2700X at home tells me that I'm probably your best bet. I probably drop right into the motherboard you already have with a BIOS update to a Giza 1004, slap in some memory, and you're good to go. Great frame rates, great content creation. Buddy, I've got 16 cores and 32 threads. That is performance that used to come from a much more elite neighborhood, and now it's accessible to you. At $749, I am not a cheap date, but I am a pretty good value. And like I said, 16 cores, the performance is gonna blow you away. So I'm a no-brainer, bud.
Wow, great answer. Processor 3, I make videos and 3D renders, but I'm still a gamer at heart. Describe what a typical day with you looks like for me.
Whew, sounds like we would be a perfect match because I work hard, but I also play hard with some incredible gaming performance. Yes, I can run Crysis. Yes, you can use my 32 cores for incredibly smooth gaming, but that's not all I have to offer. In fact, rendering is kind of my main thing. I can save you so much time rendering that we can go on a nice long walk on the beach. And I don't mean to brag, but have I mentioned my 144 megs of cache? Because I have 144 megs of cache. Software developers are going to go crazy over my prowess for compiling. All you have to do is get a new TRX 40 motherboard and I'm good to go.
Wow, great answer. Processor 2, how do you most like to use your 24 cores?
Well, as you can see, Processor 3 and I have a lot in common. We both have the same features. We both have 72 PCIe 4.0 lanes. Simply, you get more cores as you move up our stack. I have 24 cores, I have 140 megabytes of cache, and I'm priced perfectly in between Processors 1 and Processors 3 at $1,399.
Wow, great answer. Gosh, fantastic rendering capabilities, incredible gaming performance. You all seem so perfect, but I think I've made my decision. Wait, is that?
Ryzen Threader for $3,990X? What are you doing here? First of all, how dare you? I thought you weren't coming till 2020.
I am.
You have 64 cores? And is it true you also have 288 megs of cache? You're in another league. And PCI Express lanes, you have like 88, right?
You know it.
Well, that's all the time we have for today. Will Kevin ever be able to pick between these amazing CPUs? Find out on the next edition of My Perfect Processor.
Wow, what a spectacle.
That didn't really help.
Hopefully this made your choice crystal clear. But really, no matter which of these you end up going with, if you're choosing to upgrade here, you really can't go wrong.
That is true. Thank you all for watching. Please be sure to like and subscribe. And as always, if we get to 5,000 likes on this video, we'll have Dr. Lisa Su on as a very special guest.
You have that power. Mm-hmm. You can make it so.
It's in your hands.
Well, we have a little special treat in store for those of you who stuck around to the end of the episode. And until next time, bye everyone.
Cut.
Okay. I have a feeling we're never actually gonna continue that dating segment, right?
Oh, no, it's a very stupid idea.
Processor 1, do you believe in love at first sight?
Yeah. Anybody who's ever seen me believes in love at first sight.
Processor 2, what's your favorite body of water?
Well, I really hate Sky Lake, KB Lake, Comet Lake, Whiskey Lake, Cooper Lake, but I really like Lady Bird Lake.
Processor 3, what's your favorite N-type silicon dopant?
Oh, what a great question. Usually arsenic, but if I'm feeling adventurous, phosphorus.
Processor 1, who's your favorite artist?
That's easy, bud. Matisse.
What would you change about yourself if you could change anything?
More cores.